Last week, you produced a file that looks a lot like the file up on my screen, rsid.txt. It's a list of all the first 100 RS numbers in a typical 23andMe file. Each of these RS numbers we're going to use today to do a search, so make sure before you watch this video and try to follow along with the steps that you know where your file is. You may have called it call.txt or mycall.txt, but you should have a file from Canvas, and you can always download what you submitted to Canvas onto your computer. The next thing that I want you to do is go to Canvas and click on the link for Biomart Ensembl. There are many versions of Biomart that you can get on the internet, and we're going to use the Ensembl Biomart to search for information about those 100 SNPs. We'll also look for information based on phenotypes. Looking by SNP and looking by phenotype are the two best ways to get the data that you need for this project. So one thing that you learned last week is, what is the data that 23andMe sends to individuals when they ask for their raw data file? And it's very simple. It's only four columns. You get the RSID, the chromosome, the base position, and the genotype. So there isn't any information about what that genotype means. The Biomart tool is the database where we're going to get the information about the meaning behind each SNP. We'll start by choosing a database. The database we want is Ensembl Variation. The second step will be to decide which variation database we would like to use. We're interested in human SNPs, so the first human short variant database is going to be a good choice for us. And then we have to decide how we're going to filter this database. So if I click on filters, a lot of different filters come up. I could look at only chromosome 1. I could look at a karyotype band, so I could do it by physical location. But the ones that we're going to look at will be under general variant filters. So when I press this plus, I'll see two options that are very helpful for the Unit 3 project in bioinformatics. The first one is filter by variant name. This is what we can use our homework results from last week as a filter. So I could paste them in, but even more easily, because we were careful to format them, I can choose the file rsid.txt. And now I can run the count function to see how many things in the database match my list of 100 SNPs, and I get 100 results. Now I just have to choose what I want the results to look at. So I have a database, I have how I'm filtering the database, and the attributes are going to be the columns of information that are in my output file. The default is set to variant name, variant source, chromosome name, and chromosome position. That's not very helpful for the Unit 3 project, because that's the information we already have. We already know the chromosome name and the chromosome base position. What we're interested in is, what does it mean for human health? What phenotypes are associated with each SNP? So if I click on variant associated information, I can turn off variant source, chromosome scaffold, chromosome start and end, and I can add information about health. The first thing that I'll want is the minor allele. This is the less common letter at that position. So if John Wilbanks has the less common letter, he's likely to have a variation that is interesting, a more interesting phenotype. Minor allele frequency, so how common is that less common letter, and clinical significance. Then we also have all of these columns for phenotype annotation. So we can look at the individuals, we can look at the phenotype name, the associated risk allele, and the p-value. So I'm going to add those three columns to start. And now, instead of just counting how many rows in the database match my filter, I'm going to click results. When I click results, I see only 10 rows show up, but that's because the view is set to 10. So if I change the view to 100, I'll be able to see 100 rows of information. And you can see that for most genes, there isn't a known phenotype. So most SNPs in the database have a minor allele, a minor allele frequency, but it's unknown if it's associated with any clinical significance. When we set it to 100 rows, though, we can scroll down and we can see, oh, there are some SNPs that have a risk allele and a p-value. So there must be something known about those individual SNPs. We can see some of them have a phenotype name. So RS3933834, this is the one that you guys looked for last week as your homework assignment, is associated with increased BMI for individuals that have a letter G. These SNPs have a benign clinical significance, so they're associated with genes associated with disease, but they don't increase the chance of the disease. And a couple other SNPs have p-values associated with them, so they may have some interesting data. But there's really only one phenotype name in this list of 100. So what we can do is we can download the list. We want to download it as something that's easy to read into R. So it's going to be a CSV file, and click go. This is what you'll pass in for your homework this week. mart_export.txt for this list of 100 SNPs. Let me know if you have any questions, and then in your next assignment, you'll do the exact same search, but through the R tool instead of through the web browser.